Hello viewers, welcome to On the Chair. Today I have with me Veena Bhat, former Mrs. Vivacious, Mrs. Bangalore and Mrs. Karnataka, and also the proprietor of Veena Vani Wellness Center. Welcome to the show, Veena. How are you?
I'm fine, thank you.
All right. Mrs. Vivacious and then Mrs. Bangalore, and followed it up with Mrs. Karnataka. Tell us about the entire journey.
Okay, I was an aerobics instructress for 25 years, and in 2001, they had this Mrs. India Gladrax competition which was happening, and all my friends wanted me to go for it because Aditi Govitrika, she won it in 2000. And Mrs. World Gladrax. So I said okay, and then we went for it, and I didn't know what a portfolio was those days, so I had to go for a portfolio. My makeup artist Gauri Kapoor was there those days, and she did my makeup. Milton was a cinematographer and camera person, so he did my portfolio. I was selected for the auditions. I was so confident with myself that I had stitched my clothes which I had to wear for my finals for my first audition. So we had four rounds, and we stitched everything. We went there. We were 35 of us, and all were models and actresses. And I was a housewife. I was an aerobics instructress and a homemaker. So I was a little doubtful whether I could make it there or not. But I was confident enough and went there and won the Mrs. Vivacious Award.
Okay, that was for your bubbly nature. And then you followed it up with Mrs. Bangalore and Mrs. Karnataka.
Yeah, my father wanted me to have another crown. So I went for my Mrs. Bangalore, I won it, and then there was Mrs. Karnataka, and after that I started with my grooming classes.
Right. You followed it up in 2003 with Veena Vani Wellness Center.
Yes.
So what exactly does the center do?
We have, even if a normal person comes, like a lay man, we say it, models come in, and it can be boys as well as girls, and we take them. And we have a 30-hour regime for them, where we teach them skin care, hair care, and catwalk, communication skills, conversational skills, how to face the camera, how to go for auditions, the dress sense, makeup, everything is involved.
It's a comprehensive
yes,
it's a program.
Yes.
And what is the duration of this?
It's like a 2 hour a day. And those who are working, we take them on Saturday, Sundays. And we have 3 hours for them every Saturday, Sunday. And it completes within 30 hours. And then we have a portfolio for them. And we have famous photographers who click pictures, and then they get their ads. I take them to the agencies and introduce them with the portfolios. And they're selected for the movie, they're selected for serials, then they're selected for TVCs and print ads.
Okay, and is there a lot of footfall for this, for the grooming?
Every month we have that many students coming in, and I do one-to-one because there are some who are very confident in a question-answer round, and then there, some of them are insecure seeing the other person who has a better height and color. So we do one-to-one and we make them confident, and within a month makeover is done, they're very confident with themselves.
Brilliant. So you've just given them a door to, you know, knock on, so that they actually participate and, you know, actually get the titles.
Yes.
Because you've been there,
yes,
done that, you know, yes, how it works.
Yeah.
In fact, you worked in movies as well, not just won the pageant.
Yes,
yeah?
Yes. After I have completed around 120 ads, mostly it was all jewelry ads and silk ads.
ये संध्या मरुमहल है महल ही था ये नहीं
presenting Gilma Hobbs and Chimneys
so when we were shooting for Malabar Gold and Priyadarshan was the director he said I want a new face for my new movie. Till then, I didn't know who the actors were, actresses were, and who was a cinematographer, nothing. I knew about it. So I said, okay for it. And we went there and I saw there was Akshay Kumar, there was Vidya Balan, Amisha Patel, Paresh Rawal, Manoj Joshi. And it was called Bhool Bhulaiya. And it was a box office hit. So I was very proud to be in that movie.
And your association with Vidya Balan.
Yes.
Any fond memories from?
Oh yeah, like I'm a staunch Baba devotee, and she too is a staunch Baba devotee. So every day, we had a Baba Mandir just next to our hotel. Mm-hmm. So we used to go there and pray and go for our shoots.
All right. And what was the experience with Akshay Kumar?
Oh, Akshay is a real brat, you can say. So we used to play softball in between the shoots. We used to play dumb charades, and he always wanted to be the winner. So he's a big cheat and a brat, but a very good friend.
Looks like you had a lot of fun there.
Oh, we had. We used to play a lot of games, and shoots were fun, and with all these people, it was really good.
Then you also worked in sandalwood industry.
Yes.
Played a role in Eddelu Manjunatha.
Yes.
And the song, a famous song, is
Prapanchave Devaru Madiru Bharu.
Prapanchave Devaru.
The director came to my house once because he wanted some models who could play the instruments in that song. Mm-hmm. You know, like holding a guitar and playing the drums or something like that. So I was into coordination of models. So we showed them pictures and everything. And then he said, we have one more person who is going to sing this song for mm-hmm. us. And would you be interested in it? And I said, I don't know Kannada those days. I never used to speak. So he said, no, you just try it out. And I went there, and it was shot in Best Club. And it was a 5-minute song. And I didn't know Kannada. They gave me 16 pages of this song.
16 pages?
Yes.
Okay.
And it was a fun song, and it was something different. Mm-hmm. It was like a Bollywood movie song, which was just tried and tested in Kannada movie. And it was a big hit. So we shot the whole night, and it was 7 to 7 in the morning, where I did my own makeup and my own hair. I had to style my hair. I draped my own sari. Aww. So I'm very proud of it that everything was done by me.
Off the top of your head,
yes.
Would you remember the lyrics of that song?
It was called Prapanchave Devaru Madiru Bharu. It's like, it was a song for Jagesh mm-hmm. that don't drink and spend all your money in drinking. Look after your family.
Okay. That was a concept.
Yes. Okay. So it was fun, and we shot from 7 to 7 in the morning. I will never forget that day. It was the first song in a Kannada movie.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a big hit. So mm-hmm. even if I go to Dharmasthala and Kukke Subramanyam, like spiritual places, there are 10 to 12 kids will come and sing that song for me, you know.
Okay. Well,
and it's been 8 years now, and still people sing that song when I walk on the road.
That's lovely. Right. And Kanjivaram happened.
Yes.
Yes. So what happened? I mean, how did that come about? So
we just finished with Bhool Bhulaiya, and I think he wanted me to be in his next movie, Priyadarshan sir. And he said, this is again a Zamindar's wife's role. And I said, oh no, not again, because I wanted a different role in that okay. Tamil movie. But it was his dream project, mm-hmm. which was called Kanchipuram. It was a national award winner, and I was a Zamindar's wife in that. And Prakash Rai was there. And
right.
Yes. And I still remember, because he plays a servant's role in that. And though he's a very dear friend of mine, for every dialogue, you know, I used to smile at him and say the dialogue. Cinematographer and director said, no, he's your servant, so don't smile at
him. Okay.
So that was, and he knows which character, whom he has to take, you know. There was a guy just walking on the road with long hair, with long beard. He was a yoga teacher, a foreigner. So he said, I want this guy to be a Britisher in my film. So he just called him. He came, he just cut his hair, he told the barber to cut his hair and the beard and a cap with the suit, and he looked a thorough Britisher. And he comes to our house, and the zamindar, that is my husband, is showing him the sari which was woven mm-hmm. For his daughter's marriage. So he was appreciating that sari. So
okay.
Just a day's role, and Priyadarshan just picked up someone from the road and said, this is going to be.
That's
it.
Why he is who he is.
Yes, yeah. Yes.
Right. 25 long years of experience as a fitness expert.
Yes.
So, what made you get into this field?
I was in Bombay, and I just delivered my son, and he was going to a school when he was 2 years old.
Mm-hmm.
And I saw one of our friends going and doing an instructor's course in aerobics in Bombay. So I said, okay, you finish your course and then we'll all come and join your classes because we have to wait for our children for the class to get over and come down. So we had Yogita Bali, Mithun Chakravarti's wife, we had Nasruddin Shah's wife. All of us joined her class because all our kids went to the same class. You know, it was called Little Dot in Bombay near Otters Club. So we all went and I loved the choreography part. And then my husband got a transfer here. He shifted to Bangalore. And once he came here, I said, oh, we have all healthy people here in Bangalore. So why don't you start classes here?
Okay.
So that's how I started my classes on October 18th, 1990.
1990,
that's right. Yeah, so I started with one student. There were no ads, nothing, just word of mouth. Mm. And I had 150 students. And I had started for only ladies. So there were only ladies coming in, losing weight, measurements, going for Miss Indias. Mm-hmm. And only after I went for my Mrs. India, I started training other ladies to go for Mrs. India.
Right, and you actually made sure you had a qualification.
Yes.
You are trained.
Yes.
To be a fitness expert.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
From Bombay, and then I went to US, in Houston. I did a 5-hour course every day for 45 days there.
So Veena, you are also into aerobics, yoga,
yes,
and different streams of fitness. What, according to you, is wellness?
To be fit, I'll think everybody has to be fit. Mm-hmm. Because you will be slim and you'll be tall and there won't be any fitness levels. You have to check out on your blood group, your hemoglobin level when you join a class. Mm-hmm. You have to check out on all these, your cholesterol level. Mm-hmm. Everything has to be checked and then you have to join the class.
Okay.
And you have to tell the trainer what's wrong with you before you get trained. Because there are some people with low BP, high BP, and then you suddenly start exercising. You start doing warm-ups and you start feeling dizzy.
Mm-hmm.
If you have BP and if you have a vertigo problem. So it's better, you know, we have a form which they have to fill in all their ailments and what is good for them, what is bad for them, a diet chart for them and everything.
Right, and you take age into consideration,
yes,
as well.
Yes.
Considering that you have this background in modeling and acting,
yes,
a lot of girls, I'm sure, and even married women,
yes,
they come to you for advice,
yes,
like we already know. For the past 25 years, what change have you seen, the transition in the thinking and the approach to modeling and acting? Has it broadened?
Oh yes, it has, because in 2000, when I went for the competition, there were some of them who are club members and all that, they would say, at this age you want to go for Mrs. India? Don't you have shame because you have such grown-up kids? Because modeling was called
yes,
during those days.
Time.
And husband was very encouraging and I had a mother-in-law who was ailing. So she wanted me to go and participate and my children were teenagers. So it was fun and I went for the audition and was selected. We had about 4 auditions and I was one of them in the finalists there.
Okay. And is it as tedious as it was at that time or has it become easier for models now?
It becomes easier now if you have a groomer with you because you know exactly what goes on there. So we train them and we do shopping with them. So they know exactly what to wear.
Mm-hmm.
Where when we went in 2001, I didn't have anybody to guide me. So now they have me to guide them and we discuss about the colors and their makeup and fitness levels and shoes. We go and shop everything and then we send them there.
Okay, it's all given on the platter.
Yes.
Including, you know, how to take care of yourself.
Yes.
And
first thing what we teach them is skin care and hair care.
Mm-hmm.
And it's all grandmother's recipes. So we don't use any harsh cosmetic gels or face remover, this face, all the scrubs and all which we get outside. Everything has chemicals in it.
Mm-hmm.
Though they say it is herbal,
mm-hmm,
those things don't last long if they don't have chemicals, preservatives in them.
Right.
And then it's perishable if they don't add into it.
Mm-hmm.
So we make our own scrubs at home and none of us in my family use soaps or face washes.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. And you give the same advice to your students as well?
My students say you're an open book because I give them all what I do at home. whatever regime I do, I always teach them how to do it.
That's very generous, because women especially don't want to reveal their beauty secrets.
Yes.
All right. Spirituality, you seem to be very, you know, you seem to have a lot of focus on spirituality.
Yes.
During your training for these models, upcoming models, is that what you try to give them?
Yeah. You have to be spiritual, because you know there's someone there who's looking at you all the time, and you want help, he's always there to help you. So when I'm grooming them, we put this also into their head, so that you pray for 5 minutes, you meditate for 5 minutes, and that's how you reach there. Because all these competitions are, you know, some of the girls, they put you down.
Mm-hmm.
You know, however good you're to look at, or if your dress is, you know, the best out of the designer outfits which you have. When you go there, there'll be other competitors who say, oh, you don't look good with this makeup. This dress doesn't look nice. This color doesn't look nice on you. So, you know, you feel very low.
Okay.
And for that, you have to meditate. And you have to be confident with yourself, and you say, yes, I'm the best. And I can do it, you know.
All right. And it's just to put them down and make them feel inferior?
Yes. Always they do it, because when I went for my competition in 2001, there was a person from Delhi who just cut the heels of the shoes of one of the competitors, cut the bikini of someone who was going for, next day was their preliminary this, and she had to go and buy again.
Very unethical.
So you have to be so careful, and when you go for these competitions, you have to always have everything under lock and key, because something or the other, though all are matured there, there'll be something or the other going out from your, like your makeup box or your tights or your you know, swimming trunks, everything will be just gone. So you have to always have a lock and key to all your
bags. That's experience speaking for all your upcoming models out there. So do you train men also?
Yes. We do train them, and they are all into movies now. Most of them are into movies and serials.
Mm-hmm.
When we were doing coordination, even this Karthik Jairam, very close friend of ours, he has done a lot of ads for us, Britannia and all this beer ads. And he has done so well for himself. I'm very proud of him. He's reached a level, and he's done Star Plus as a Ravana. He's acted in Siya Ke Ram.
Okay.
So, all my students have done well, and I feel very proud. It's like feather in your cap when you hear all these, you know.
I mean, what you've gained from your experience to impart it and actually see someone come up.
Yes.
Itself.
Is
something.
There was one girl called Veena Bhat, who was a very close friend's daughter. She was a basketball champion, and she was always like a tomboy. And her aunt, Vinaya Prasadji, wanted me to make her feminine. And it just took one whole month. And this baby was 20-year-old. She used to go shopping, and then she used to WhatsApp me, ma'am, can I wear this dress now? This is very flowy, and this has got prints on it. And and that girl has, Miss Diva South, Femina South, in 2014. And she's just acted in Puneet Rajkumar's movie last month.
Brilliant. So there's still hope for tomboys out there. So you can still come to Veena, and she'll turn you into a princess, I guess. So Veena, how would you define image?
It has two categories. One, those who are short, you know, those are just 5'2 and 5'4. They too come to me for grooming. So when these people come, they can't walk the ramp. They have height limits for ramp walk. They can't go for competitions, because you have to be 5'7 and above.
Mm.
And guys have to be 6 and above for this Glad Rags Manhunt. Then there is a different category for them. All have to be above 6. So those who are short, we train them, and they go into serials.
Mm-hmm.
They go into movies. They go into dance competitions. An image is, I would say, they have to be confident. If you're confident, you can reach anywhere.
It's the essence of a person's personality,
yes,
rather.
Yes.
Does a person communicate his or her image only verbally, or is it just what you see?
They have to have everything. That is height, then they have to have confidence. Most of them don't have confidence when they come,
mm-hmm,
because they don't know what is communication skills. They don't know how to walk the ramp. And if they have to be a model, they don't know what all goes into it. So here we are to teach them everything, and they are confident enough. Those who have a problem in speaking English, we put them with a teacher who can do communication skills, and they teach English speaking courses are there. We put them there. Some of them can not speak Kannada because they're all Punjabis and, you know, North Indians who can't speak Kannada. So we have a Kannada tutor for them to teach the language. Mm-hmm. There are Tamil tutors to teach them Tamil. So usually in a movie, they need a new face. So when a person goes there and she's 18 to 22 year old, she can be an actress. Mm-hmm. Because after 25 years and all, they will be sisters and aunts and all that. So it's only 5 years in this industry where they can be a heroine. Mm-hmm. And then there are other category, like, you know, all the women who have reached heights in Kannada industry and Tamil industry. Mm-hmm. They're still into movies called Ramya Krishna. All of them are there. They're still above 45, 50 and they still act. Mm-hmm. So you have to have that passion to work for it, or and you have to have confidence, I would say, again and again confidence, because when the light is on you and the camera is on you, they forget their dialogues. So for that, they have to go for a theatre training classes if they are going to go for movies, act in movies.
Okay.
So there are courses for different...
kind of direct them.
Direct them, yes.
How they can keep reinventing
yes.
themselves.
Yes.
Right. Okay, and what about communication? You have trained your models, upcoming
yes.
models in communication. What are the key skills that you actually train them in?
First thing is eye contact.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have something called facing the camera, and we ask them question answers, because all this competitive, whatever we have, competitions which go for Mrs. India or for the male
mm-hmm.
section, we have manhunt and all. They have to answer questions. First is an introduction round where they have to introduce themselves, and in that introduction, we write it and give it to them, the introduction, so that we give them 6-7 points where, you know, they have to say that, so that judges will say, yes, we want this girl or this boy to reach the finals. It has to be a little hyped and all that. Then some of them were Mrs. India's and they were grandmothers. So we had to say, yes, you know, she has a 5-year-old granddaughter.
Okay.
So the judges said, yes, she's doing and she's very fit. So we have to, we should see that she reaches the finals. Because that's a, you know, trigger for them that, yes, I've got this baby with me and I take care of my granddaughter and all, blah, blah.
Nice. So etiquette,
yeah.
We know we come from different social backgrounds,
yes.
we come from different cultures. How do we blend into a setting? What are the few rules, ground rules that we can follow?
We teach them etiquettes too, because most of them, when they reach the finals, they have this, there's one evening of cocktail round for them, where they have to mingle with other people and they have to talk to people. They have to introduce them to all the people. So that's where we teach them etiquettes, how to hold the glass and how to hold their spoon and fork, and how do they sit and how do they stand and how will they walk. And even when they stand with those people, how much distance they have to go apart, because you can't be falling on everybody there. So the marks get cut off. So they've got marks for everything.
Mm-hmm.
How the room has to be clean, their clothes have to be ironed and kept inside, their makeup, you know, morning you do your makeup and then you just rush for your choreography and your walk. They come to your room and they check whether your makeup is all set and neatly kept.
Oh my God.
So your wardrobe, your bags can't be kept open in
okay.
the rooms. They have got marks for everything. So that's how you have to see that you get maximum number of marks everywhere so that you reach the finals.
And is this something which is told to...
No, they don't. Even when I went for this competition in 2001, I used to get calls that, oh, you went to this restaurant today, or you went to this party today. So there were people
oh my God.
who would judge you in Bangalore, thinking, where all is this lady partying and how is she socializing with people? And is she very rude to people? Or does she back answer to people? Or does she use bad words? You know, all that is taken care of. And when you go there, you know you have got marks for everything.
Mm-hmm.
And that's why I think I was like a mother hen there, because I was the oldest in the whole group and all the kids used to come and sit there. And, you know, they wanted some tips from me and I used to give them tips. But, you know, all of them wanted to be, they all said, we want to be like you when we grow your age.
Okay.
So that was a plus point which I got. Tanas Karim was with us. Mm-hmm. It was a nice event.
Quite a few memories you've got, haven't you?
We had to go to the gym. Mm-hmm. And out of 19 of us, I think only I went to the gym. All of them have got zero because they didn't go. Because they have a person, the security person watches you whether you're going to the gym or not. Oh. Exercising or not. And they give a minus there. And when I saw my chart, I had every day I used to go for class.
And when do they show the chart?
When we are doing the preliminary round.
Okay.
Yeah. It's just 2 days before your main competition where you're selected for the sub-events. Mm-hmm. So you get beautiful hair and beautiful skin, mm-hmm. beautiful walk and personality, vivacious.
So there's no faking?
There is absolutely no faking. Nothing. That's why we train them to be perfect when they go for these competitions. And for me, my students have to win and come. It's like that.
Right.
Because all my students have won. I can't say, okay, you should be there and you have to win and come. That's it. So I give them all the clues, what to do, what not to do, and they do that and they win that.
Right. Pretty intensive and custom-made, I guess, training programs would be then. Veena, how does a person build his or her fashion sense?
When they come for grooming, we check on their height, and their fitness levels, mm-hmm. because if they are a little overweight, we give them more exercises. So when they get fitter, then we go and shop for them. Mm-hmm. If they're going for a competition, those who are very slim, it's good for them. They don't have to do anything else.
Right.
They just have to be fit. So those who are a little on heavier side, we teach them all the hip exercises and stomach exercises and all that.
Image. What meaning does it have for you, and how much has the concept changed from the days, 25 years ago when you started off to now?
Those days, girls didn't want to go for modeling. Some of them wanted to go only for acting. So we had to groom them for acting as well as for Mrs. India or Miss India's or whatever. So image, when they come in, some of them are short, some of them are tall. So we categorize them, and those who are very tall, we take them for fashion shows and we send them for competitive shows. And those who are very short, we train them for serials, mm-hmm. and they go for movies, they go for dance competitions and music competitions too.
Right. Yeah. So you have a career for everyone who comes to you.
Yes.
You try to train them according to you, try to see where they fit the bill.
Yes.
And you push them towards that.
Yes.
Commendable. So what are your thoughts on motivation? I do know that your wellness center also is deeply involved in motivating individuals. Tell us about it.
Some of the girls and some of the ladies who come, some of them are encouraged by their parents and their husband, mm-hmm. and their families. Some of them are not. So some of them just come here to me and say, my mother-in-law doesn't want me to go for it, but I want to go for it. Then we work on them. Mm-hmm. We make them fit. We make them beautiful and all that. Then speak to their in-laws or their parents and their husband. Husband usually are very encouraging, but parents in-law, some of them, mm-hmm. are very orthodox, so they don't want their daughter-in-law to come on stage. So when they come in, we see their skin texture, we see their hair, how it is, and after the whole grooming is done, we send them to a parlor and we get a good haircut for them which suits their face, mm-hmm. and we take them to good designers to design their clothes, because when you go for a competition, you're there for around 12 days or 5 days. So every day you have to wear something morning and evening. Mm-hmm. You have to do your own makeup there. Early morning you have to wake up, go for your exercises, come back, have your breakfast, do your makeup, and again start
all by themselves.
Yes. So we train them for all this, so when they go there, they know what is, mm-hmm. makeup and they know what is catwalk, so it's very easy for them to learn the choreography when they have already learned their catwalk.
Have there been instances when the in-laws actually came back to you and said, we are glad that you took her to that level of winning a competition?
Yes, we have a dentist who is coming to me, and her mother-in-law had checked my website, and from Delhi she has sent her daughter-in-law to come and train under me just before marriage. She had a very bad skin because of her studies and all. She used to scratch her pimples and all that, so she had left some scars on her face. So it's been around 40 hours, and she's got a good skin now, and her mother-in-law is very happy. She calls me up every day, thanks me for it, because she sent pictures to her mother-in-law, and I'm glad that even before marriage or bride-to-be, we just train them. It's not only for competitive levels which we groom. All of us, I think we have to be groomed to look good. And I love when my students walk on the road, when each of them will look back at them and cheer them up and say, oh wow, this girl is beautiful, this girl's figure is beautiful.
You feel complimented.
I feel very complimented, and we motivate them to be there for the finals. Every day we drill into their head that yes, you are the winner, you are the winner.
Right.
So that's how they make it there.
So you also go to corporate houses and offices and
yes,
train probably freshers or also people who have already been of
yes,
experience?
Yes. Here what happens is we have ladies working in the corporates and they want them to do basic makeup. Usually they have a uniform, so some of them can't drape their sari well. So we teach them how to drape their saris, what hairstyle will look nice
mm-hmm,
for them, because they have to meet the client and they have to sell their product all the time
mm-hmm,
when they are into marketing. So we have a makeup course for them, which is basic makeup, sari draping classes. And most of them want fitness because they're always sitting on a chair. And we have some facial exercises for them where they don't get wrinkles and their skin is always clear. We teach them facial exercises, we teach them wrist exercises, we teach them chair exercises, because whenever they go, they have lunch and they come just before their lunch, 10 minutes they can do their
mm-hmm,
chair exercises and will keep them fit. As it is, they're running around and then they sit in front of the computer, so they need exercises all the time.
Especially with posture,
yes,
and
yes,
you know, sitting in the same position, and also
yes,
the eyes, like you said.
Yes.
Right. And I think even the air conditioning system affects your skin,
yes,
etc.
And they affect your hair too,
mm-hmm,
it becomes very dry. So we have to give them hair packs and all that,
mm-hmm,
how to make it at home, and they apply it and they're very happy, you get feedback.
Okay.
Yeah. And then we have this in-house grooming where we have groomed Hyundai staff. There were about 5 showrooms and each showroom had about 100 to 150 staff members.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to teach them how to smile at the clients, how to, you know, hygiene. Everything we had to.
So Veena, I'm sure you have students who get out of college freshly and they're getting into the corporate space. What is your advice as far as you know, behavior and you know, communication, etiquette, all those parameters that you have? What is your advice for them?
First of all, to be confident, because they have to go for interviews. You know, the MDs will all sit with them and interview them, so they have to answer well. And they have to pause, so they have to, and the eye contact has to be there. What they have to wear while going for interviews, we train them for that.
Mm-hmm.
And hygiene, they have to put their perfumes and DOs and smell good. And their skin, they have to wear basic makeup. They just can't be a plain Jane and go for corporate interviews. Their shoes, we go and shop for their shoes. And we buy their corporate, you know, skirts and their trousers and all.
Right.
Some of them, they have their uniform, but some don't. But for corporate, you need to wear a particular, you know, attire for it. So we go and shop for that.
And we work long hours, you know, in the corporates, usually men and
yes,
women, and there's so much of traffic also to add to that. And to look your best at parties and weddings and gatherings, what is your tip? How do we work around the schedule of office hours and then look our best as well?
See, first of all, we have to take care of their skin. So we have the scrubs which are ready and made at home. They have to use their scrubs. They have to use minimal makeup, basic makeup. Let them do their eyes more, but see that they don't use too much of base on their face.
Mm-hmm.
Something they should eat the right diet should be good, because you're going to eat and splurge on food because of Christmas and New Year's. So you have to be careful on your food and shouldn't eat oily food,
mm-hmm,
shouldn't eat too much of sweets,
mm-hmm,
otherwise your weight goes up and it'll take another 1 year for you to
get it down. Okay. And what about care for the hair?
Hair, we have hair packs. I would like to give a tip here. It's like 1 tablespoon of olive oil, 1 tablespoon of glycerin with 1 egg white beaten. So just mix everything, and you have to make partings in your hair. Just use it with cotton.
Mm-hmm.
Leave it for 30 minutes and then wash it with lukewarm water with mild shampoo. This will stop your hair fall, it'll make your hair look thicker and it grows faster.
Right, right. And what are the upcoming projects for you?
My Kannada movie, which is the 24th film, is going to be released next month, called Luti with Isha Kopikar.
All right.
Yeah.
Okay. And anything happening in Bollywood yet?
Bollywood, soon. I'll let you all know.
All right. Okay. Great. We look forward to it. Now, I will not let you go without a rapid fire round. Okay.
Sure.
First impression for you is?
The eyes, attire, and the makeup.
And I'm too sexy for dash.
For my looks.
Okay. I never walk out of my door without
makeup.
Essential. Okay. You are outdated if dash.
I think I'm like wine. I will not get outdated.
Wow, that was one hell of an answer. And you know that you've made a lasting impression when dash.
Was when I was selected for my Mrs. India competition out of 35 people.
So Veena, something for our YTV viewers?
Be fit and confident.
Short
and there
and
you'll, yes, and be happy and keep smiling all the time.
All right, thank you Veena for being on our show. Thank you viewers for watching our show. We'll see you again next time. This is Arfa Siddiqui signing off. You take care.